The subject of this short tutorial is correlation analysis and outlier detection. We have the COVID-19 data set which we will be using for our analysis. This is our COVID-19 data set. We must have already come across this data set. But first we need to know what we are trying to analyze here. As we know, correlation analysis involves studying the statistical association between two variables. It measures the degree to which a pair of variables are linearly related. So we have many variables that we could analyze here. But for this tutorial, let's look at just these three variables: the new cases, new deaths, and new vaccinations. But before we begin this analysis, we might first have to enable the Excel data analysis tool pack. To enable this tool pack, let's first go to File, go to Options, go to Add-ins, let's come below, and here in Manage, let's go to Excel Add-ins, let's click Go. So here you have these add-ins, and if this analysis tool pack is checked, no issues. If it is unchecked, please check it and click OK. Now doing this, we enable the data analysis tool pack, and that can be accessed in the data section of this ribbon. And here you have data analysis. Right above solver, you have data analysis. Now that we enable the data analysis feature, let's start our correlation analysis. And as I mentioned earlier, for this analysis, we'll have a look at these three variables. So we don't need the other variables, the other columns. Let's delete these columns. Now, let's first have a look at the correlation matrix. To access this correlation matrix feature, let's go to data analysis, and you have various analysis options. Let's go for correlation, click OK. And here we might have to specify the input range, the output range, and other options. So let's select the input range. Input will be these three variables. Let's select these three variables, and then yes, these three columns have labels in the first row. Let's check it. Then the output range. The output can be either in a new worksheet, new workbook, or in the same worksheet. Let's have it in the same worksheet. So let's click the output range and just drag your cursor for these many, an arbitrary number of rows and columns. Let's have it for these many rows and columns, and let's click OK. And this is our correlation matrix. So these correlation values will be between -1 and +1, 1 being absolute positive correlation and minus 1 being absolute negative correlation. Here we see for new deaths versus new cases, there is a 0.84 correlation coefficient value. This says that there is a very good positive correlation between new deaths and new cases. But for new vaccinations and new deaths, we said that there is a 0.23 correlation. There is a positive correlation. 0.23 is above zero, so there is a positive correlation, but the correlation is very weak. It's not so strong as it was for new deaths and new cases. Now that we saw the correlation matrix, let's see if we can gain more insights by plotting these values in a scatter plot. So to insert a scatter plot, let's go to insert and let's first select the data. Let's first plot new cases versus new deaths. Go to recommended charts. Let's go to all charts. We need a scatter plot and we need the second plot. In the x-axis we have the new cases and in the y-axis we have new deaths. This is the plot that you want. Select it, click OK. So this is your new cases versus new deaths. Let's plot a trend line. Go to this chart elements, come down to trend line, click it. Let's increase the width of this trend line, make it thicker, and let's use a solid dash type. Let's change the color to red. So here for new cases versus new deaths, we see this trend line. We already saw in the correlation matrix that there was a strong positive correlation between new cases and new deaths, and we see a similar thing in this chart. Let's plot another chart for new deaths versus new vaccinations and let's see how that plot looks. So again, let's go to, so we want new vaccinations in the x-axis and new deaths in the y-axis. So let's have a similar structure. Let's copy this and paste it here so that we get new deaths in the y-axis. In a similar way, let's go to insert, go to, let's first select these two columns, go to recommended charts, all charts, XY scatter, and let's click this OK. Let's move it to the top. This is new vaccinations versus new deaths. Let's add a trend line. Make this trend line thicker. Make it a solid dash. Change the color to red. So as we see, again, as per the correlation matrix, the correlation between new deaths and new vaccinations was weaker, but it was a positive correlation as we see from the trend line. The correlation is positive and the slope of this trend line is much less steeper than the slope of the trend line for new cases versus new deaths. This has a greater slope because the correlation coefficient was 0.84. It had a stronger positive correlation, and here we see there is a much weaker positive correlation, but nonetheless it's a positive correlation. So we see that initially when the vaccinations were low, the deaths were high. But as the vaccination kept increasing, the number of new vaccinations kept increasing, we could see a decrease in the number of new deaths. So if we were to compare these two charts, we can see that the new vaccinations seems to have had a positive impact on the number of deaths. Number of deaths seems to have decreased, but we cannot make any conclusions from these charts. Based on this analysis, we can only go further and conduct further analysis to see if indeed the new vaccinations had any impact on the number of deaths.